So marketing email platforms, some of the advantages, well, you can mass email thousands of people in a minute. So imagine if we have a list of 100K subscribers, I'd need a lot of email accounts to email them all at once, right? So that's not a point of it. So that's why we use MailChimp, SendGrid, and Intercom to send our emails. So that's one of the advantages. It's very easy to design, so you can create these pretty HTML emails with images and all kind of great stuff, links, etc. And it's great, as I said, for newsletters and blogs. If you have a lot of blog posts, you can do that. Some of the disadvantages, while you're sharing one server with a bunch of other companies, emails usually end up in a promotional marketing folder. It's different a little bit for Gmail and Outlook, but basically you'd end up mostly in a promotion marketing folder. If you get a lot of bounce rate, bounce rate you usually get, if the email doesn't exist or you're not cleaning your emails regularly because, people leave companies and there are a bunch of other server issues that I'm not going to get into. But if you're getting a lot of high bounce rate and you're doing a lot of cold email, basically you're going to get kicked out from these platforms. And again, it happened to me some 5-6 years ago. So that's definitely going to happen with these platforms. Now, some of the marketing results, because you're sending lots of emails, are, somewhere, it depends again from industry to industry. By no means I'm suggesting that this is your standard, but in B2B, this is what you get. In B2C or e-commerce, you tend to get a bit higher numbers, but this is what you get B2B. Now, the sales email platform, some of the advantages is you can automate follow-ups and some tedious tasks. Again, whether it's a follow-up on a contract, whether it's a follow-up on an invoice, whether it's a cold email sequence. So you can automate all these kind of follow-ups. All of the emails are very personalized. They're going out from a technical perspective, from your servers, from your emails, so you are sending them. Again, think about it. You schedule a campaign and then emails go one by one. The server went, the product went like 2-3 minutes, then sends a second, the third, the fourth, the fifth email, etc. So it's almost like you're going in and sending those emails. It's just that you automated that part to an external product, right? And obviously they're very, very targeted, which is a big advantage. Now, disadvantages, realistically, you can send more than 500 emails per day. That's limited by your email provider, such as Outreach, such as Gmail, G Suite. Although we always recommend you get the G Suite, which is the business account for Gmail. So around 500 emails and you're safe. And of course, in the beginning, you need to set up your cadences. You need to learn ropes, such as if you're sending 10 emails a day, tomorrow you can send 500. From a Gmail's perspective, Outlook's perspective, it'd be like someone hacked your account. So they'll block you for 24 hours. Okay, so start with 10, move on to 20, move on to 50, move on to 100 the next day, etc. So slowly work your way up.